In this example, we are required to find the heat current through the frustum of a cone shown in figure. We are also given that the temperature of its two ends are maintained at T1 and T2 respectively, and its thermal conductivity is K. We can see that the cone, the frustum of cone which is given to us, is not uniform. So, in this situation, we can first find the thermal resistance of this frustum. And directly we can use the relation for the heat current as temperature difference by the thermal resistance. So directly we cannot find the resistance. What we can do is, from one end, say the ends of the frustum are A and B, then from end A at a distance x, so we can consider an elemental disc which is of width dx. Now if we consider a disc of width dx, several such discs can be considered to be connected in series from end A to B. And say if this disc is having a radius r, its radius can directly be given as the radius in this frustum is linearly varying from r1 to r2. So by using similarity of triangles formed in the frustum, we can write the radius is equals to r1 plus r2 minus r1 by l into x, as it is at a distance x from one end. Directly you can get the relation by drawing the perpendiculars and using the similarity in these triangles. Now if we find out the thermal resistance of elemental disc, this can directly be given as dr thermal is equals to 1 by k into dx upon pi r square. This 1 by k, the separation of the ends divided by its area, and as all these elements are in series, we can write the total thermal resistance as R thermal can be written as integration of dr thermal, as all these discs can be considered in series. So it will be 1 upon pi k, it is integration of dx upon r square. The radius we can write as r1 plus r2 minus r1 by l into x whole square, and we'll integrate it from limits and a to b, that is from 0 to l. And here if you simply integrate, I'm just writing down the simplified final expression after integration, which you can verify. This thermal resistance will be 1 upon pi k into L upon R2 minus R1, and after substitution of limits, so we'll get it 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. On further simplifying, we'll get the result to be L upon pi k R1 R2. Now, if we are having the thermal resistance of this system, we can directly write heat current by using Ohm's law for thermal conduction as dq by dt is equals to T1 minus T2 divided by the thermal resistance. So the result will be pi k R1 R2 T1 minus T2 divided by L. That will be the answer to this problem. The only point which I have directly used is the analysis of integration, which you can simplify and verify at your end.